Little Ken Speaks here, starting an impromptu build that I wasn't originally going to film and upload because I was building a 3D printing some figures for a friend of mine who requested some figures. He started by wanting a figure of Thanos from Marvel, and I found a bundled file on Gambody that has Thanos and the defeated Iron Man on Titan on a rock base, and Thanos is holding his Infinity Gauntlet up in the air, and Tony's all beat up, his helmet's off, he's all chewed up, in that famous scene in Infinity War. And initially I was just gonna print it out, put it together, and then primer it for him and give it to him to paint. I started working on it, and I decided to do some lighting on it, and then I decided to make one for myself. So I'm going to end up painting it, and I'll probably just paint both of them for him, one for him, one for me. So I have most of the figure of Tony completed and put together and lit and started to paint him. So let me show a quick slideshow of the parts for Tony and the Infinity Gauntlet. And the rock base, he's sitting down on a rock base, piles of rubble, and I wired in an LED for his chest arc to glow. So let me get and show you those, and then I'll show you where I am on this build so far. Okay, so as you can see, I completed the figure of Tony, and he is in 1, 2, 4 different pieces. His whole upper torso, his whole torso, and his two arms, and the spike through him are all one piece. His head is separate, and his two legs are separate, and they fit together very nicely. Quite a bit of nice detail on him. I especially like the face sculpt. That looks really, really cool. That's a good sculpt. All right, so I already have wired into him a little impromptu place there for him to get the tube through. As I showed in the previous still, I took an aluminum tube and I had a set actually of 4 LEDs. Let me see if I still have one here. I have one around here somewhere. Hold on, sorry. Okay, so I think these are 3mm, pretty sure. Just cool white. And I had a set of 4 of these already wired together into one set of leads. And so I just cut them off, and they're just 3 volt. And so what I did was I took a piece of aluminum tube, and I just took this down through it until it snugged up against this part. And then I just took some 5-minute epoxy and coated this whole thing and the aluminum tube, so that it was on a slight angle. Because what I had to do was take it up through the torso and angle it a little bit towards his chest, because I'm lighting up that little arc reactor there, little circle with the outer part on it too. So right now I have that masked off with micro mask. I did that on both of these. And as I said, one for me, one for him. And I'm just gonna get and paint them. He's not a model builder, but he wants to kind of get into it a little bit and do some of the figures. So originally I was just gonna do the rest of this, the rock base and the Thanos figure, and just get it painted and give it to him and let him do the rest. But since I'm gonna paint one myself, I might as well just do both and give him a nice painted one, since I'm more skilled at it, obviously. So this rock base is the part that Tony sits on. He sits right onto that little part right there. And you can see there are some places for his feet. And then on this half, this side here, you can see there are some connectors. It's kind of hard to see with the clear resin, but there's another part that comes out this way, and Thanos stands on it. So Thanos is going to be standing on here, and he's going to be facing him. And when I print that out, I'll end up gluing them together and having them both on one stand. And then I'll have the wiring going down through, and it'll just go into one coin battery. So you can see I hollowed it out. I drilled a hole where Tony's sitting, so the tube just goes right down through it. And I opened up a spot, and that's plenty big enough for a coin battery, and that'll easily light two of these LEDs. Those are only going to be two lights, one for his arc reactor in his chest and one for the Infinity Glove. So I'm going to be running some wires up through one of the legs of Thanos, up through his arm, and into the Infinity Gauntlet. And I have those micro masked off as well, getting ready to paint those. Now mine, I masked off all 6 Infinity Gems, even though at this scene in the movie, he didn't have all 6 of them. In fact, he really didn't even have the one on the thumb, which is the time gem. He got it shortly thereafter, because this is a scene where he defeats Tony and stabs him with his own spike, and he's ready to kill him. And Dr. Strange says, you know, spare his life and I'll give you the stone. And Tony's like, no, don't do that. He's like, I have to. So he gives him the stone, he puts it in his thumb, but he's still missing this one right here in his hand, which is the what it's called, the one that that Vision has in his forehead. So he has not yet gone to Earth and captured that one. So I'll be lighting this up as well. Pardon the train sirens in the background. It's just, I live in a town where there's a lot of trains going by, so hard not to get one while I'm filming. So all right, so here's the 2 rock bases that I made. Those are okay for now. This one has to be drilled out as well, and hollowed out or cut out for the battery also, which I'll get to when I need to. But right now what I'm doing is working on the Iron Man. So I put flat black over both of them, so I masked off any light coming through, since they're clear as well. And then I went ahead and put some Tamiya fine surface primer gray over top of it, so I could see the detail. And the portions of his armor that are still intact, I'm going to paint with a flat aluminum. And then I'm going to go over it with a clear red to kind of give it that armor look. And I think that's going to give me the look that I want. The rest of the parts have to be painted differently. Some of it's going to stay silver. And some of it is his jumpsuit underneath. So, all right. But I'm going to go ahead and get some silver down onto him. And then we'll start looking at painting his armor. All right, so I went ahead and got the flat aluminum onto the figures, as I showed in my previous stills. You can see a little bit of that still shining through on there. And then all I did was I painted over that, airbrushed over that with some clear red to give it a metallic look. And I think that came through pretty nicely. You can see like a metallic glint from there. And I can touch up a few spots, and certainly a lot of these parts on him are going to be painted with gold and silver and that sort of thing. And then weathered to make him look dirty and dusty. I don't want him to be really shiny like this, because at this point with all the rubble and dirt, he's not really clean at all. But I think that's going to be it for the airbrushing. What I want to do now is go to just hand brushing, because I got to do his outfit, the various metals, the various panels, that kind of thing throughout him. So I'm going to do some screenshots, some stills, take a look and see what, get an idea of what I want to paint this, and then start working on that to get the different colors on, and then get the other one painted with the red as well. Okay. All right. So I finished with the airbrushing. And I went ahead and started on just using a brush to paint on the other details. I'm using some flat aluminum and I believe it's Titan Gold from Tamiya. And just painting some different parts. I know some of it isn't screen accurate, but it's kind of hard to get some shots of some of it, and I'm going to have to do some touch-up when I'm done. But I'm getting most of it. Then I can go over with some gloss red again over the parts that I need to. And I'm going to start getting his tunic painted as well to kind of get that contrast of colors in his suit. And then I have to work on the other one. Okay, so I got quite a bit more painting done on him. I got his tunic with a neutral gray. I highlighted the lines in it with some red. I still have to touch those up. Got that silver done there in the broken off part of his outfit. And on the back, I have a couple of colors of gray on there as well. And I finished doing some of the painting on the back of them. And a lot of this is going to be toned down, the glossiness, with some Tamiya weathering powders that I'm going to use, make him look dirty. I also removed, let me go back a second. Obviously, I got the flesh on his face, an initial coating of some flesh, which I'm going to be working with. I'm going to do a lot of dirt on his face, and he has some blood marks on him that he was injured and that kind of thing. So I always save like the eyes till last, because they're the trickiest, and I want to be careful with that, not mess those up. But he's coming along pretty well. I got the open parts on his legs where his tunic is sticking through, and a lot of this I still got to touch up. I use some of the flat aluminum on some of the edges of his armor, as if it were exposed metal where it would not be red, that kind of thing. Which would be odd anyway, because it's nanites recreating itself, so I don't know quite well how that works. But I removed the panel for his chest, for his arc reactor, because I'm done painting anything with airbrushing. So let me go ahead and put a battery on that. I did take a little bit of clear blue and I thinned it out with just some clear and made it a really pale blue, so it's not really bright and obvious. But let me go ahead and show you how that's going to look. I think it looks pretty cool. All right, there we go. So I think that turned out really awesome. It gives it kind of that blue glow, but it's not overpoweringly blue. The camera actually makes it look a little bluer than it really is. It's just more of a blue tint to it. So I think that turned out great. It's going to look really good. And that'll be weathered and dirtied a little bit as well to go along with the rest of his outfit and that sort of thing. So a lot of the gloss is brought down on him. So Okay. So he's coming along well. I still have to repeat those on the other one, but I'm just going to focus on this one for now. I'm not going to show you the rest of the video, me building both. I'll just do one and kind of show you how it's going to look. And I'll just repeat the process, obviously. So, okay, so he's coming along really well. All right, so I'm ready to go ahead and glue one of the LEDs into the gauntlet. Now, this particular one, I drilled out, or basically hollowed out the gem there, because he didn't have it yet. This is the scene on Titan when he's fighting Tony, and this is the last one that he gets right here on the back of his hand. Technically, he kind of didn't have this one on his thumb, which is the time stone, but he got it shortly thereafter, so I'm going to leave that one on there. So all I'm going to be lighting up would be all the ones on his fingers, the five, painting those different clear colors. So what I thought I would do, I hollowed this out a little bit more, is I want to put a whole bunch of 5-minute epoxy down in there so it fills this whole cavity. Dab a little bit in that little hole which that created, so that's solid. And then embed the LED down into the 5-minute epoxy, so it's basically spreading the light throughout the gauntlet. And of course, this is all going to be painted black, and I'm going to use some metallic pale gold on it, so everything else is going to be darkened except the parts that are masked right now that I'll peel off. And I'm just going to do the whole glove in the gold, and then I'm going to weather it. And then I'll have the wire coming out. That'll go down through his arm, through the rest of his body. I did do a little bit of a test. It can be fished through without too much trouble, but it's not going to be long enough in the end. But what I can do is fish it down through the main parts of him, and then I can add on to the wire at the end and take it down through the rest of the way. And at some point, one of the parts, maybe like his boot or his leg or something, I can have the part that's connected on, which will be a little bit thicker. So, okay. So all I'm going to do is use a toothpick, some 5-minute epoxy on a piece of cardboard, put it inside there, get that positioned inside so it's the right place where I want it, and let it harden. All right, there we go. So it's mostly set up in there now. Try to get that to focus, come on. So it's hard to tell because the whole thing is kind of glowing and there seems to be a hot spot, but it's distributing the light pretty well because it's solid resin inside of there now, clear resin. So in real life, I can see a bit of a glistening off of those blue masked parts where the gems are going to be. So once I get this all masked, it's gonna keep the light inside even better and make it brighter, and then it'll just glow through those spots that I want to. So, okay, so I will let that set up, and then I'll get this, start getting this painted. All right, so I did complete one of the gauntlets. I think it turned out really, really well. So what I did initially is I just spray painted it with some Krylon flat black. And this actually comes out more of a satin. I know it's supposed to be flat black, but it's really not like your doll flat like you would from Tamiya. So I was going to just use the black originally for the light blocking, and then I was going to paint on the gloss black from Alclad, which is a shinier paint. And then to get it to be shinier, but it was a nice satin finish. Like I said, it was pretty smooth, and this part is pretty smooth. So I did a little test on the bottom just brushed on some of the pale gold Alclad. And it didn't react with the paint. That was my main concern. Sometimes the Alclads will react with other paints. You've got to be careful. It'll start to pull the paint off because this is a different type of a metallic lacquer versus like an enamel or an acrylic. So no issues with it. So I went ahead and airbrushed it on the rest of it, and I think it turned out really good. It's nice and shiny. I still want to weather it a little bit, give it that dirtied look, but I think it looks really, really cool. I think it's perfect. So then I pulled off the masks, and I used some Tamiya Clear and just painted the different colors. So you have orange, red, blue, purple, and green. And as I said, I didn't do that one on the back of the hand, so I just made that look like a cavity. It looks like it's missing a gem. So let me go ahead and put a battery on that, and I'll show you how that looks. All right, there we go. So there's the green one on the thumb, which looks really cool. Looks like an actual crystal. I think it's pretty cool how that turned out. Then you have the orange, the red, blue, and the purple. The purple might have to be touched up a little bit. They don't make a clear purple in Tamiya. Oh, come on. So I just mixed some blue and red, tried to get a right color. I may try to brush that off and maybe paint a blue on first and maybe go over it with a light red to make it look a little more purplish tone. But I think that's pretty cool. Let's get that out of the light. Okay, so that's glowing pretty good. All right, so I think that's pretty awesome. I think that turned out how I wanted it to be. And he's going to be holding this up in the air in front of him. and he had just gotten the time stone. So he's getting ready to disappear and go to Earth and get the last one. So he can do the snap. So, all right, fantastic. So, really like how that turned out. And how my Iron Man is turning out. I'm ready to start, printing out the rest of Thanos and start getting him built as well. All right, so that's gonna go ahead and wrap it up for this week on this particular build. And I got a lot accomplished, and a lot of the lighting has been hashed out, and I think it's looking pretty cool. With the arc reactor in Tony's chest and the Infinity Gauntlet, I think they're going to be pretty awesome. So, mostly got the Iron Man figure painted, and I begun printing out Thanos, and he has several parts, and he's actually much larger than Tony is in this build. Obviously, because in real life in the movie he's much bigger as well. So I'll continue to work on this, and I should be able to wrap this up in the next video. Because I just have to work on Thanos now, and I've already gotten the lighting done in his gauntlet. So it's just a matter of printing him out, getting him painted, put together, and then doing something on the rubble base that they're both sitting on, and getting that, getting a battery and a switch in the bottom. So I have been looking into expanding in the 3D printing realm. Because I really love my 3D printer. My Elegoo Mars is fantastic. And obviously I've really been doing a lot with that as opposed to some other things. So I've been looking to get a larger one. And for the longest time, Elegoo has been talking about releasing one called the Saturn, which is roughly about 2 times the size, I think, than the one they currently have. So they had a pre-order here a few weeks ago, and they had an early bird of $200 for $300, and then another $800 for a total of $1,000, and those $800 were $400 each. So they gave the time, the date, I was ready to go, got on there. They sold out in 2 minutes. So 2 minutes, I was very frustrated. Pretty much just, okay, I'm not going to get this. It's not going to happen. That's just crazy. So I just kind of forgot about it. a good friend of mine, Augie Gonzalez from Interstellar Modeler. Keep wanting to say Starship Modeler. I'm sorry. It's Interstellar Modeler. Had sent me a message and he said, hey, did you see this? They're doing a second wave. So I went ahead and looked at Elagoo's. I believe it was their, it was either Twitter or Instagram. And they were announcing a week later they were doing another 2,000. This would be their last batch because it was to capacity. And they would be doing 2,000 of them at $400 a piece. So I got on there and I was able to get one. So very excited. It was $400 plus $100 shipping. Now this particular batch, the first batch is coming out early in August. The second batch not till the middle of September. You know, assuming that nothing delays it, of course, with all the things going on. But very excited about that. And I mentioned that because I also had talked about my friend and him wanting to get into 3D printing. So he's looking to buy my Elagoo Mars from me once I get the bigger one. Sell that to him at a good price, like $100, and give him a nice printer to start with as well, because I really loved it. But I will continue on this build, and we should get this wrapped up in the next video. And I think it's going to turn off fantastically. All right, thanks again to all my new subscribers, and stay tuned. Lots of great stuff happening, and I'm really working on a whole lot of things all at once. So thanks a lot.